السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا أعزائي الطلاب في الدنيا خمس ساعات المقبلة، يسعدني إن إحنا نتكلم مع بعض في الدكتور خمسة سيكس واللي بتدرس في السكن. إحنا شفنا كده الشابتر 2، دلوقتي هنشوف الشابتر 3 ممكن هنا. الجزء دوت بعنوان ديسكريبتيف ستاتستكس أو يوزنج أمريكان ميجرز بارت 1. الجزء بتاع الشابتر ذا فيرست جول كومبيوت أند انتربريت the mean, mid-mean, and median, the mode, and quartiles. The second goal, compute and interpret the range, interquartile range, variance, standard deviation, and coefficient of variation. Third goal, describe the shape of distribution and compute the coefficient of skills. The last goal, compute the mean and the standard deviation for group data. The first part measures location, which we call central tendency measures, and the five measures. The measure around is the arithmetic mean. Second measure is weighted mean, median, mode, and quartiles. The five measures do we call averages. The most common question is, "Only calculate the best average." In few cases, we start with the arithmetic mean. Few cases, then we start with the weighted mean. Few cases, then we start with the median, mode, and quartiles. الفيرست بارت ان احنا هنشوف الارثمتيك مين مره في الكومبيتيشن مره في السامبل. اي انجلش لتر يبقى خاص بالسامبل، اي جريك لتر يبقى خاص بالكومبيتيشن. الارثمتيك مين وذا سامبل اكس والشرط اللي فيها دي ريد از اكس بار سم اكس ديفايدد باي ان، ان سمول مينز سم سايز، النيو جريك لتر مينز الكومبيتيشن مين، سم اكس ديفايدد باي كابيتال ان وش از الكومبيتيشن سايز. اكزامبل فيرست اكزامبل. A population consists of 6 observations. This means the capital N equals 6. The values of these observations are 8, 12, 7, 4, 10, and 13. Calculate the average of the population. Mu equals sense. Mu equals sum x divided by capital N. 8 plus 12 plus 7 plus 4 plus 10 plus 13 divided by the populations of 6 will produce 9. So the arithmetic mean of the population equals 9. Another example. A sample of 5 workers. Selected randomly. Sample of, this means sample size, small n is equal to 5. The following are the salary per hour for each. 14, 15, 17, 16, and 15. Calculate the arithmetic mean of the salary. Since we have a sample, the arithmetic mean of the sample is x bar equals sum x divided by n. 14 plus 15 plus 17 plus 16 plus 15 divided by 5, 15.5. The weighted mean. The definition of the weighted mean is the sum of the efficiency multiplied by the respective weights divided by the sum of weights. If there is a mean and weighted mean, for the weighted mean, each observation must have a frequency more than 2. 2 or more. The arithmetic mean of the weighted mean is x bar of w, weighted mean, sum x w divided by sum w. Given that x is a variable, we need to calculate the arithmetic mean of it. W is the weight for each observation. Assume that a random sample of 26 repair projects has been selected. The following data are available. Days to complete, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, and 8 days. The frequency and number of projects. 4 projects, each project needs 5 days to complete. 12 projects, each project needs 6 days to complete, and so on. Find the mean. The days is the variable x. The frequency of the number of projects is the weights for each. So the first value of x is 5 days and its weight w1 4. The second value of x is 6 and its weight 12. So the arithmetic mean of the weight or the weighted mean is sum xw divided by sum w. So the numerator will be 5 times 4 plus 6 times 12 plus 7 times 8 plus 8 divided times 2 divided by 4 plus 12 plus 8 plus 2. You will find the arithmetic mean 6.31 days. Now we are going to calculate the median. The difference between median and mode, the mean and the median, sorry. The mean needs asymmetric data, no extreme values, very high or very low. But the median can be deal with the extreme values because we need to sort the data from smallest to largest in ascending order, and then the second step find the median location, which is n plus 1 divided by 2. So the definition of the median is the middle value of the sorted data. Find the median of the following data set. 19, 25, 7, 16, and so on. The last observation is 220. This data is unsymmetric data because we have very extreme value, very high, 220. So we cannot find the arithmetic mean or calculate the arithmetic mean. We need to calculate the mean. Step one, we need to start with sorting of the data from smallest to largest. As you can see, the smallest value is 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and so on. The largest one is 220. The median location equals n plus 1 divided by 2. The number of observations n equals 17 plus 1 divided by 2 will produce the ninth observation. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. Then the ninth observation is 15. In the middle of the sorted data, then the median equals 15. Another example, find the median of the following data set, 19, 25, 7, 16, and so on. The last observation is 210. This data is unsymmetric data because we have here 210, very high value, extreme value of outlier, and 3 or 4, extreme value, very low. The first step, we need to sort the data from smallest to largest, 3, 4, 5, 7, have up to 210. The median location, n plus 1 divided by 2, 16 plus 1 divided by 2, equals 8.5. 8.5 observations location means the median lies between the 8th and the 9th. The 8th, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, the 8th is 14. And the 9th is 15. The 8th plus the difference between the 9th and 8th times 0.5, which is 8.50. Then the median equals 14.5. The mode is the most frequently valued of the data. If we have one mode, then this distribution is called unimodal. If we have two modes, this is the distribution is called bimodal. Three modes, this distribution is called multimodal. One mode, unimodal with one peak. Bimodal, the curve is two peaks. Multimodal, the curve is more than two peaks. Find the mode of the following data set. 1, 2, 2, 5, 6, 6, 6, 7, 7, and 10. The mode is the most frequently valued. 6, we have the frequency of 6 three times, then the mode is 6. This distribution coming with one mode, it's called unimodal. Another example, find the mode of the following data set, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, 7, and 10. There is no mode. The correct answer is null. Another example, find the mode of the following data set, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 7, 7, and 10. The most frequently 4. The observation 4, its frequency 4 times, the observation 7, its frequency 4 times, then we have two modes, 4 and 7. No any mathematical operations of the mode. The first value of the mode equals 4, and the second value of the mode equals 7. This distribution is called bimodal. Quartiles, if we have unsymmetric data, means extreme values very low or very high. We need to sort the data from smallest to largest. So the very low values will come in the at the beginning of the data ordering data, and the very high values coming at the end of the ordering data. We split the data to two equal quarters, 25%, 25%, 25%, 25%. After removing the first 25%, which is very low values, we will find the first quartile, which is Q1. After removing the last quartile of the data, which is very high values, we will find Q3. In between, we'll find the second quartile, which is Q1. So Q1 is the observation coming after remove 25% of the sorted data, and Q3, the observation which will appear after removing the last 25% of the sorted data. The location of Q1, our Q1 location is N1 plus N plus 1 divided by 4. The location of Q3, N plus 1 divided by 4 times 3. Q2 is the median, and it's coming after 25%, 50% of the data, or coming after two quarters. Assume that we have the first data, 16, 11, 12, 13, 17, 16, 220, 20, 18, and 21. We need to first calculate the first quartile and the third quartile. First step, sort the data from smallest to largest as follows. The smallest is 11, 12, 13, 16, 16, up to 220. Q1 location, n plus 1 divided by 4, 9 plus 1 divided by 4, 2.5. This observation lies between the second and the third. The second observation is 12, the third is 13, 12 plus 13 divided by 2 equals 12.5. We need to calculate the Q3 location. N plus 1 divided by 4 times 3. 9 plus 1 divided by 4 times 3 equals 7.5. This observation lies between the 7th and the 8th. The 7th observation is 18 and the 8th is 21 divided by 2. The third quartile is 19.5. Now we are going to explain the measures of variability or the measures of dispersion. The first, we need to understand the range, interquartile range, then variance, population variance, sample variance, standard deviation, population standard deviation, sample standard deviation, and coefficient of variation. The range is the maximum value minus mean value, the largest value minus the smallest value. In this dot diagram, we have one observation, its value 1. One observation, its value 3. Two observations, each value is 5. Null observations with value 6. One observation with value 7. Three observations with value 9. One observation with value 10. Null with value 11. Two observations with value 12. One observation with value 13. And one observation with value 14. The largest value is 14. And the smallest one is 1. The range is the largest between the minus the smallest. Then the range is 13. Interquartile range. An interquartile range is called IQR, interquartile range, equals Q3 minus Q1. Semi-interquartile range is interquartile range divided by 2, SIR, S-I-R, Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Assume that we have the following values in 1,000 of the items sold by a furniture company in each month during 2018. In month January, the value is 51,000, February is 53, 54, 5, 50, 5, 61, up to December 51. This data is unsymmetric data. In April, the sales was 5, very extreme value, very low. In November, 750, very extreme value, very high. We cannot calculate the arithmetic mean or the range. We need to calculate the quartiles, Q1 and Q3. Semi-interquartile range and interquartile range. The first step, we need to solve the data from smallest to largest. The smallest is 5 and the largest is 750. The total number of observations is 12 observations. Q1 equals N1 plus 1 divided by 4. 12 plus 1 divided by 4 equals 3.25. Then the first quartile lies between the third and the fourth. Or in other words, the first quartile coming after the third observation by one quarter. The third observation is 51. The fourth observation is 53. I need one quarter after 51. Then the first quartile Q1 equals 51 plus the distance between the fourth and the fifth, 53 minus 51 divided by 4. Then I get one quarter after the third. Then the first quartile will be 51.5. The third quartile location, N plus 1 divided by 2 times 3, then the third quartile location is 9.75, coming after the 9th and before the 10th, or coming after the 9th observation by 3 quarters. The 9th observation is 61, the 10th observation is 62, then the difference 61 minus 62, 62 minus 61 divided by 4, this gives me 1 quarter. Times 2 will give 2 quarters, times 3 will give me 3 quarters. I need 3 quarters. Then the third quartile is 61.75. IQR Q3 minus Q1. Then IQR interquartile range equals 10.25. Semi-interquartile range, the interquartile range divided by 2. 10.25 divided by 2 equals 5.125. Thank you, my students. See you in the next lecture.